Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. My name is Steven, aka Storm, and we are back for some more of the Elder Scrolls Online as we wish, the Mighty Battle Lizard. And I am a little breathless, sorry, I just had to run down some trash to throw out because my apartment was getting cluttered, so I'm just quickly getting the invite to send out to everybody. Right, it's time to get underway. So we are just a week out from the launch of the Deadlands DLC. So I'm not going to start a DLC and work on, you know, clearing out whatever's left on that. That's going to take too long with Clockwork City, which is the only DLC left that we haven't gone and completely cleared out. Because we're done with Somerset, we're done with Southern Elsewhere, we're done with Northern Elsewhere, we're done with Mirkmire, we are done with Western Skyrim, we are done with the Reach, we are done with Blackwood, which is over here. So today we're going to be finishing up some space game stuff here in Stonefalls, and if we have time we'll go down and do some stuff in Dishaun, and then of course next week when Deadlands is out we will be starting the Deadlands DLC on the week that it launches, so look forward to that. I have no idea how that DLC is going to go. I have been avoiding all kinds of like story spoilers. I know a little bit about some of the coming mechanics and stuff that's coming with it, like the changes to hybrid sets and the curated loot drops, which is going to make farming gear a whole lot easier. Not completely. It's not going to completely fix the problem with gear farming, but it's going to make it significantly easier. And then, of course, the new armory system, which is what we're going to be implementing to turn Rewish into a true battle lizard by using both lightning and... I don't know this guy. Can you sling the axe? Who's this guy? Darn it.
Riches and wealth.
Oh, this is the Undaunted quest.
Well, Scam, you don't look any worse for wear. Maybe you should put the ale down every once in a while and pick up a sword.
Okay, I'm not going to do that right now because I've already got the Undaunted quest skill line, I'm pretty sure. Oh, that gave me some gold, sweet. Pretty sure I already have the Undaunted skill line. Oh, I've also been working on my Ledger Domain skill. You'll notice that is currently up to 7. I'm working on that in the background currently. Yeah, Undaunted 4, yeah, we don't need... I'm so sorry. Weather's been shifting back and forth the last couple of days, and it has got my allergies all over the place, which is probably why I'm so breathless at the moment, is because of that. Alright, we're going into the Crow's Wood. Oh, and hey, our bounty is 69. Nice.
Magic, so temperamental. I hope you're not here to attack me. If I die before I stabilize this portal, you'll be trapped here. Since killing me is off the table, I could use some help.
What kind of help?
My father, Rulantaril, is missing. He disappeared from his workshop in Davin's Watch. I think his disappearance has some connection to this place. I want to know what, and then find him if I can.
What do you know about his disappearance?
He was there one day and gone the next. His notes call this place Crow's Wood. It's the only clue I have. I thought I saw an old house up the trail. Could you take a look? I need to stabilize this portal.
I'll check out the house.
I must concentrate. The portal will close. Excuse me.
What is this place?
We're in a pocket of oblivion. Everything you see is crafted from illusion and metaphor. Even the grass beneath your feet is just a memory of grass. Your mind is struggling to make sense of the chaos around us.
A pocket of oblivion?
Technically, the Crow's Wood is part of Everglow, one of the realms of Oblivion. It is the realm of perpetual twilight, ruled by the Daedric Prince Nocturnal.
You seem to know a lot about Oblivion.
I've spent most of my life studying Oblivion and the various methods of fighting Daedric threats. The Tribunal is wary of Daedra, and with good reason. Nothing good ever comes from Oblivion.
Why was the portal that brought me here inside a chest?
Perhaps I didn't think it through. I was hoping it would prevent random passers-by from entering the portal. I suppose I should have disguised it as something less intriguing. Well, live and learn. Since you're here, I could use some assistance.
All right, let's go. Before we do anything, pop an experience scroll to make the most use of our time. That was a mistake. I shouldn't have dropped down over there. I thought I could access the Sky Shard quicker if I did that. I'm hoping somebody hasn't come through and cleared out a bunch of this area. Oh yeah, base game content. How I have missed how simple you are. Dang it! I just dropped back over down over here for nothing. I gotta be careful or I'll be eaten alive by Slaughterfish. Or technically the memory of Slaughterfish. Oh hey! First boss. Thank goodness I'm a lizard, though. We can swim around much faster. Yep, that's mostly what we're going to be doing today, is collecting sky shards. Racking up ye old-fashioned skill points. Yeah, advanced chests are up to a 15% pop rate, so we're not ready to start popping those yet, but I'm making it easier to pop chests. Also locks, so that way if we have to do any more lockpicking in the future. Hello, Neva Rook.
Halt, intruder!
A talking crow? Hey, Imshark.
You have entered the domain of the Black Feathercorns. You must pay the toll, flesh or silver. Choose!
And if I refuse?
Then, well, things will go badly for you. Droppings on your shiny clothes. Yes, that's it. An incessant cawing will keep you awake all through the night. Do not cross Blackfeather Court, intruder.
I'll humor you, Crow, for now.
There are two tolls you can pay. The toll of flesh or the toll of silver. Choose.
Should we do the toll of flesh or the toll of silver, Imshark?
Commits you to fight our enemies, the wretched bats of this wood. Each time you kill a bat, we'll descend to feast upon the bat's tender bits.
I'm ready to choose.
Speak then, featherless one.
I choose the toll of flesh.
Then we shall feast on our foes. Will you kill 4 and 4 of the flying rats? Find the seneschal of Carrion.
8 bats? I can do that.
Pay the toll or pay the price. The something, something rhymes with rice. Yes, almost got it. I'm not good at warning rhymes yet. Don't look at me like that.
Don't you recognize me? We met in the Clockwork City.
The Clockwork City. That place of metal. Metal and more metal. I hate that place. Let us never speak of it again. Now, do you have any plans for your entrails? you no longer need them, perhaps we can come to some arrangement.
Okay, I liked how they went back and they added a little thing there if you had completed the Clockwork City before coming here. Charred notes. The stupid witch has given me everything, so eager for a companionship, despite desperate for a friend other than that pestering birds of this miserable corner of Oblivion. She taught me all the magic I wanted to learn. The minister of the... Clockwork City was supposed to be after this, technically. The Magister of the Black Feather Court taught me binding spells, Daedric magic, all of it, all at her command. Her price was so ludicrous. I've never been so pleased as I was when I locked her in that blasted tower. No bargain is going to drag me back to her side. I'm taking everything with me. I'll burn this house to the ground and leave the witch in her tower to rot. Yeah, I'm currently working my way back through some of the old stuff. Hey, your father is a bit of a douche.
Chilling. Look at this place. It was deliberately set on fire.
You might want to take a look at these notes.
Interesting. Why was my father here? And who is this witch he mentioned?
Tell me what you want to do now.
I stabilized the portal, but it's not going to stay that way. I need to attend to it. Would you go to the court my father mentioned? Maybe someone there knows of his fate.
I'll find the Blackfeather Court. Alright, so we have to pay the toll of flesh before we find the Blackfeather Court, but there is a boss to find and fight first before we do even that. Is it in this one? It is in this one, but it's currently down, so I will drop a waste point there. We'll go try to find the next one. There's a giant bear around here somewhere. Oh dear. Sorry, wolves. And this one's down too. This person must have done it. We'll come back. I believe he's farming the area, so I gotta be careful or I won't end up getting any of the bosses in this area. That's not where I wanted to go. Not yet, anyways. I do want to go that way eventually, but not yet. Nope, still down. We'll come back. And this person's actually killing all the bats before I can find them. One of the downsides of playing MMOs.
Keep your guard up until you've got your footing.
No, come on, let me out. Okay, that's a doctrine of not having a lot of stamina. When you get locked in place, you get locked in place hard. By the way, there is a nice little Easter egg right over here. Inscribed flute. This flute has inscribed on the side, a gift for Malik to his son Malik. If you're not aware, that is Malik the Liar. This flute has quite a bit of this flute has quite a bit of possibilities to it. But of course, Malik is a liar, so he could have just inscribed this that way to hide the cover of the fact that he's just one Khajiit, and not, you know, Khajiit that's been going across the ages. I pay the toll of flesh.
The court is fat and happy. The bats are dead, and we have fed. Eyes and wings and skin and ears, such tender bits. We are pleased with your tribute, Featherless. The Duke wishes to speak with you.
Well, good.
The Featherless has paid the toll. Let this be known throughout the wood.
Hello again, Duke of Crows.
Featherless approaches, approaches!
The Senchil said I should speak with you, Your Grace.
Indeed. Your efforts will be rewarded, my featherless subject. You are the first to satisfy the terms of our toll. I hereby bestow
hey, Joe.
You citizenship in these woods, as well as vassal servants to aid you. Welcome to Crow's Wood, fledgling. Take care of your new vassals, fledgling.
Don't you remember me? We met in the Clockwork City.
Did we? 1,000 pardons. But you featherless giants all look the same to me.
I also saved you from the entrapping shinies back in Blackwood as well. Court Magister.
You want something, featherless?
Do you know, Rulenthal?
Ah, yes. The Dark Elf. He was a diligent student. If somewhat crass. Talented, to be sure. But there was something off-putting about him. My suspicions were confirmed when he locked Mother in the tower. Of course, she got her way in the end.
I don't understand how she'd get her way.
Crow Mother is lonely. She doesn't get many visitors, and we, her children, aren't the best company. Hard to believe, but true. We agreed that if we'd teach Rulantaril the secrets of magic, he would return to her side.
Now he's back here?
Yes! The bargain's power brought him to her side and locked him in the tower. It's just as well, really. You want to talk to them? Rulantaril left his tower key in a ruined structure nearby. It's in a cursed chest with a fiery guardian.
I'll find the key. Thank you, Magister. Medium armor increased to 30, which is good. I need to get it to 50 as soon as possible.
Take this one seriously.
Two of the bosses. How you doing today, Jeff? Okay, that was weird. He was actually eating his own corpse because he died so quickly between deaths that his corpse was still left behind for him to munch on.
I'm still here. Thanks for asking.
Intruder, are you here to take him away from me?
Alright, we have a choice coming up. What an oblivion are you?
Why recoil so? Am I truly so hideous? Would you spurn me as Rulantaril did years ago?
Is Runenthal here? His son, Tilbaril, is trying to find him.
Yes, Rulantaril is here. We made a bargain, but he thought to renege by binding me in this tower. He still fights me. He doesn't want to stay. Make him see reason.
Make him honor our agreement.
I don't understand. Tell me about this bargain.
Sweet Ruland Real came to me, another niece of the Nocturne, to learn the secrets of the forgotten magic. In exchange, when the time came, he was to return to keep me company. That was our bargain, sealed in blood and arcane wounds.
So he didn't adhere to his part of the bargain?
He tried.
I know precisely how I'm going to deal with you.
Do you know? Very well, Truder. Tell me.
Okay, we have three choices. We can make him honor his agreement to her. We could say you're a foul, malicious deceiver. I'll destroy you and destroy her. She is a hag raven, mind you. Or I can say it's clear you both deserve to die and kill both of them. Give you guys a minute, see if anyone wants to vote. Okay, so that's one for make him honor his agreement. Okay, so we're going to go with M-Sharps and make him honor his agreement. You shouldn't be alone. I'll make Runanthar honor his agreement.
Thank you. He's raging in the corridors below us, trying to blast his way out with magic. The magic we taught him. Please, don't kill him. I don't want to be alone.
I'll try not to hurt him. His son's not gonna like this, but... His dad should have known better.
Enough, curse you! I yield. The witch gets her way. Bickering? I think there'll be a lot of bickering when my son gets here.
You have a son? I can't wait to meet him. He can stay here with us. There's plenty of room.
Great. Just great.
That's true. They just, you know, require that you give them your, you know, your soul. So when you die, you go to oblivion and suffer in oblivion for all eternity. I'm sure that's much better than...
They're coming for us.
It's not always your soul. Now, that's true. It's not always your soul, but usually it is. Could be the soul of innocence. That is also a fair statement.
Free.
Alright, that's the group event done. Now we just have to go beat the other bosses that I haven't been able to beat yet, and then we're done with this place. Dang it, they killed him again already. We'll have to come back and hopefully he'll be up the next time we... Or we might just have to wait there for him. And then, where is... Korn? You know what I miss? I miss the McDonald's coming out with the McDonald's glasses. I used to love getting the McDonald's glasses when they came out. I could have sworn the boss was like right over here-ish. I guess I'm wrong. Is it up there? It's probably up there. We'll go back that way in just a moment.
I really don't like your odds.
He's still someone's got to be farming these bosses because I'm gonna have to wait and farm and camp them in order to be able to get them probably. Yeah, I may as well just sit here and wait. Shouldn't hopefully be that long. Sorry, it may take just a minute to get these last three bosses that I'm missing. Should be really soon. They don't take that long to respawn. There we go. All right, that's another one down. This guy is still down. Go ahead and stand here and wait for him. Sorry, it's taken so long. Hopefully this will get up quickly and we can be on our way to the next one and then get out of here and get to the Sky Shard hunting part of the day where it's going to go really quickly. There we go. We've got a purple ice staff of the Red Mountain too. Is that one I haven't required before? Nope, I have gotten that one before. Okay, we're gonna go through here. We can stop running the spiders every 5 feet. So I have bad news about your father.
You're back. Did you find my father?
Your father's in the tower with the Daedra Lord. It's a long story.
He's alive, though. Aeon, bless you, my friend. I'll get things squared away here and make my way to the tower. I can't believe my fortune running into you here. Thank you for your help.
Can I talk to him again?
Father is going to have a hard time explaining this.
Yeah, that's going to be interesting. Your dad got hitched. You have a new mother-in-law, or you have a new stepmother. And it's not one you probably want as a stepmother. Now, that's the kind of stepmother that you staged an intervention on your dad about. Oh, good, I'm now upstanding. I accidentally stole something earlier when I was trying to talk to somebody. Alright. So we're going to go after the Sky Shards in this area now. Once we're done with that, we are done with this zone, and we can move on to the next one. Is that we're going to try to do as much as we can in base game zones today. That we've already played through the story of, and then we're going to just launch into Deadlands next week when it's out. I think first things first, we need to go to the one that's here. Congrats on standing up. I'm confused on that one, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm taking away your shiny glowy thing. Sorry, guys. Alright, what's left? So, watching lions swim to shore. That's the lion. Okay, I know where that one is. Let's do that one next. It's somewhere right over here-ish. Yeah, I know exactly where this one is. Right there by that statue. Found it. Alright. Next one. Wait, that wasn't that one? That must have been Lady on a Cliff, okay. Among fire, pools of fire above Vex Way Shrine. Oh, you swim faster in lava. I didn't know that. That's an interesting fact to know. Alright, that's another one down. Tucked away on a grotto's mantle. So we're looking for a grotto. That's a grove, not a grotto. Interesting. Well, I'm fairly sure to watch the lion swim to shore. It's going to be over here. So let's go get that one first. And then we'll worry about this mystery one. I forgot I can travel straight to the Harbridge because this is my alliance, so I don't have to go around. I can just go straight to the Harbor Edge. That's pretty cool. Oh, there it is. Yep. All right, one to go, and it's the one that's tucked away on a grotto's mantle. Be just a second, I am looking to see what I can find. Oh, I know where it is. Honestly, surprised I didn't think of this sooner. By grotto, it means fungal grotto, the grotto, the dungeon. I didn't think of it because I thought surely I must have already picked up that sky shirt that was outside the grotto, but apparently I didn't, which is why we're having to go back here now. Huh, I didn't know he was right outside here to give you the quest. Yeah. It's actually a really quick quest, I just don't see any reason in doing it since I already have the Undaunted skill line. I mean, free experience and gold, sure, but not really an important thing at the moment. Boom. That's it. Stonefall Sky Shard Hunter collect or Hunter acquired. Oh, and a Sigic portal. I'll take that.
That should fetch a fair fetching price.
Right. We're going to go into Deshaun the correct way. Hey, Fader, how are you? Welcome to the stream. A little chilly, yeah, I can understand that. It's pretty yucky out where I'm at today, too. I think after the stream is done, I'm gonna make a cup of hot tea and have some nice hot tea. Woo! Alrighty, let's take a look and see what we're missing here. I actually didn't get the sky shard that's like right over here. What was wrong with me? We shall see. I'd like to resume Klein, but it's definitely something I would like to do. I may need to run out to the store for some things, so we'll see. I have to, like, I think you missed it early in the stream, but I said that I needed to clean up my apartment a little bit today too, because I realize it's becoming a bit of a mess. I need to do a quick inventory and see if there's anything I'm lacking. If there is, I'll run down to the store, and then afterwards we can start Klein. But we may not start Klein immediately after, because I gotta clean up the house, the apartment a little bit. It's becoming a huge mess again. Like, I had to step over trash just to put down my chair earlier. Ah, this is the disease for vampirism. Ooh. Excuse me. There may be a sky shard over here. I don't know if I already picked this one up or not. We're about ready to find out. I've done Deshaun enough that I know where most of the sky shards are, probably just intuitively. But you never know. So that's why I'm riding back here to check to see if it's back here. Nope, I already got this one. Okay. And then I completed down there. I completed here. I did the delve. I did not do the public dungeon. So let's go do that public dungeon next. Shame, shame, shame. It is, you know, working all week and other things just stacks up, and then I forget to take it out, and it happens. Judgment of Saint Voloff, which is, you know, a really powerful warhammer, actually. Judgment is actually quite a broken weapon. Forgotten Crypts. I think my experience scroll is still going for another hour. Let me double check that. You're being judged. Hey, at least I'm not being judged by the Squirrel of Judgment, because I am writing and creating my novels. So the Squirrel of Judgment has not looked at me in 14 days. 2 weeks.
I need someone to help me get past the barricade inside the crypts.
Who builds a barricade in a crypt?
Refugees from Narsis. I came here to escape the plague, but were set upon by highwaymen. I was separated from my group and my husband. Please, I must find Gariel, but the halfway to the barricade won't let me through.
They'll let us through, or we'll find a way around.
Amalexia, bless you. I'll follow your lead, but I'm afraid I'm not very good in a fight.
These crypts could be dangerous. Stay close. And look, right away.
You can make it. Keep moving. We must keep moving. The sooner we find Gariel, the better.
Where are we? What are you doing?
I'm sorry. It's the cinnamon-scented perfume I wear.
Cinnamon perfume?
It was Gariel's favorite. I may have overdone it today.
Cinnamon perfume?
Go away. If you're infected,
we're
you'll kill
infected,
us all.
We're not infected, you idiot. I'm trying to find my husband.
I don't care if you're looking for Nerevar. You're not getting in here.
This is getting us nowhere. There's got to be another entrance through the crypt. Beck, I hope you're watching.
Mary, did you just disappear? There you are.
Quite a bounty. I'm glad I don't have to carry it. Back
We got here just in time. Alright, there's the first boss, but it's currently down, so we're gonna go and try to find the next one. Also down. We're just not having good luck with these bosses today. And another one that is down. Good gravy. And Timothy the Sharp is down, as well. That's all the bosses that are, they're all down. I guess people must be farming for Mother Sorrow currently, because that's...
Look, my husband's bow. He's been here. We must get past that door. This looks like a back entrance, but...
Intimidate, open this door, I'll tear this whole place apart. From the other side, you hear a quiet shuffling, a pause, and a loud click as the door unlocks.
I don't see my husband anywhere. This doesn't feel right.
I'll look around and let you know if it's safe.
Something feels wrong here, but I can't put my finger on it. You don't look infected. I guess you're all right.
Have you seen Sela's husband?
Garion? He's not with us anymore. If you want more than that, you'll have to talk to Danis.
Why do you keep the door locked?
To protect us from the undead and those who carry the plague.
How did you find the food? How did you find food in these crypts?
Scavenging and hunting. Our leader, Danis, has had remarkable luck finding fresh meat.
Meat? All I've seen are skeletons and ghosts.
I've no idea where he's getting it. Why don't you ask Danis?
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
You're not wanted here, outsider. For all we know, you're carrying the plague.
What plague?
The Loder's plague. It's been ravaging our cities, turning our loved ones into walking corpses. We came here to escape it.
What happened to Sela's husband?
Gariel was infected. He seemed fine at first, but the infection became obvious during one of our hunting expeditions. I had to abandon him in the crypts. I doubt he survived.
I mean, it looks like a chicken leg he's waving around, but I'm fairly certain that's not a chicken leg.
None of the refugees will answer my questions. It's like they're hiding something.
Your husband isn't here.
What? But we saw his bow.
Duras said he was infected and had to be banished.
That's preposterous. He was fine when we were separated. Please, you must find him. Search the crypts. I'll keep questioning the others. Someone must know what Darnus is playing.
All right, we have two choices here. We can say, you'll be safe here. I'll find your husband. Or you're not safe here. Get out now. These guys are cannibals. Get out now. So, yeah, we're going to go with that one then, since I have two people voting for that. You're not safe here. Get out now.
Probably right. This place doesn't feel right. I'll be outside waiting for news of my husband. Please hurry.
Okay, quest.
I hate the thought of Gariel wandering through those godforsaken chambers all alone.
You may not like what I find.
I understand. But if there's even a chance...
If he's alive, I'll find him. Started a bitter peel. He's down. Yep, they're eating Dunmer. They're eating their own people's flesh. And they don't even know it. Hey, you guys already respawned? I'm gonna go see if any of the bosses are up real quick before we... Timmy the Sharp is down. Favelin Tavani is down. The Forgotten Sheriff is down. And the Silent Colossus is down. Okay. What's wrong, M-Sharp?
I don't want to hurt you, but now I'm going to.
Oh, was that a delayed reaction to the cannibal thing? Like, oh gosh, they're cannibals. I could have never known. Like, how are we supposed to have known that? This is not like there were any signs that they were cannibals. Except for, you know, they had fresh meat inside of a crypt, like, seriously. Thank you. Well, we've gotten one of the bosses so far. We still have to get Timmy the Sharp, Tilvani, Silent Colossus. We're probably just gonna have to camp them like we did last time once we finish this quest. As much as I don't want to do that again, but I'd like to get this done before we move on to the next thing, so. Luckily, this will be the longest thing we have to do in the... We actually did quite a bit of the zone the first time through. There's just a few side things that we missed. Hello, Dennis.
Our ways are not your ways, outsider. Don't meddle in things you don't understand.
I found Garl.
Did you now?
Also found the journal he kept. I know your secret.
Spare me your judgments. We do what we must to survive. I've watched hundreds die from the plague. Horrible, painful deaths. My people are safe here. But they must eat. Something had to be done.
And when Garl discovered the truth, he banished him.
Gariel was weak. He didn't understand the need for moral ambiguity. He threatened to turn the entire camp against me. That was unacceptable.
Okay, we have two choices. We can say, you're sick, I'm putting an end to this madness, or I understand you had no choice. Moral ambiguity. I mean, in a life or death situation, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. And that or die. I'll show you moral ambiguity. So that's one for, I'm gonna put a stop to this. Anyone else wanna vote? Okay, so you're sick. I'm putting an end to this madness.
You would doom my people to starvation or death by the plague. That's truly madness.
We already made a cure for the plague, dumb nuts. By the way, it doesn't let you kill him.
A newcomer, eh? I hope you'll stay for dinner.
That poor lady.
What in oblivion are you doing? I'm getting out of here.
I'm fairly certain this meat is not actually pork, even though it's listed as pork down here.
How dare you judge us? We do what we must to survive.
Yeah, I've destroyed your food stockpile.
What? Do you have any idea what you've done?
Tastes like chicken. Giving you a second chance. Lead your people out of here.
It's that simple, is it? Just leave. Return to the outside world and forget what we've done here.
Life is never simple.
You sound like Gariel. Perhaps you're right. Perhaps we have...
Put down the damn human... Or the damn elf leg. To do so.
I can never return. This... This is where I will die. Farewell, outsider. May you never know hunger.
Chunk of meat, yeah. Like, may you never know hunger. No, I mean, I kind of get where they're coming from. Like, they did what they had to survive. It doesn't make it right, but they chose to live instead of starve to death. That was their choice to make. Now, him hiding that fact from all the people, that was a mistake. That was something unforgivable. Like, that should have been something that he talked with the group, and then they decided to starve to death, you know, they could starve to death. But he shouldn't have forced them to become cannibals. That's where that went wrong. But at the same time, like I said, you know, if you're faced with hunger and you have nothing else to eat, I can kind of understand, like, that part of things.
I really don't like your odds.
As long as they weren't murdering people for the food. If they were, like, taking the bodies that were in Boone down here, I mean, that would be, like, the height of... Oh, God. Can you... That's why there's all the ghosts and stuff and undead around. Because they violated one of the tenets of their beliefs, and they've angered their ancestors by eating their bodies. See, Altmer don't have this problem. Altmer burned their dead. For the most part. I think the Dureni were the only Altmer that didn't burn their dead. Orcs burn their dead. Bretons don't. Red guards definitely don't. Oh god, if a red guard burned the dead, it would be a really bad thing. Alright, we're gonna wait for the Silent Colossus to spawn. Yep. There's one. Okay, there's one down. We got two more to go. We already got the Forgotten Sheriff. Oh, cool. All right, one more to go. And he's up. Oh goodness, we're getting out of here a lot sooner than I thought we were going to. There we go, we're done. Let us get out of here. Yeah, I'm fairly certain if she stayed there, she would have been eaten by the people. I don't know. I've never tried. So I've never tried telling her to stay there before. So I don't know for certain if that would have happened or not.
There's trouble brewing here. Stay alert.
Have I got that, Dolman? Yes. Hello, Sela.
Have you found anything?
Girl is dead.
I know. Ever since that bandit raid that separated us, I knew. But I must thank you, Sarah. You helped me pursue my foolish hope, even at your own risk. You let me forget what I already knew. I had seen my Gariel for the last time.
Complete quest. All right. Accidentally popped out my mic there for a second. Sorry about that. It's a bullnet chance floating along with his creepy eldritch tentacles, cause it's a tentacle monster in your Elder Scrolls. tentacle monster. It's got a bunch of weird little tentacles, tentacle monster, it's coming for you. It just wants to be your friend and wrap you with its tentacles because it's a tentacle monster. It's got no face at all, how does it even eat? Like seriously, how does this thing consume anything? There was a sky shard like right over here. But you gotta believe in something. Nope, I was incorrect. There's not a sky shard here. But hey, look, it's Raynor Vanos. Hello, Raynor.
Stranger. I require your immediate assistance.
What happened to you?
It's not important. My sister Kirith went into that Dwemer ruin, but she forgot to take my new control rod. I built it to deal with the spider constructs that infest the place. She may not believe me, but she needs that rod.
So you want someone to take this control rod to her?
Precisely. I do it myself, but one of those fetchers stabbed me when I tried to go after her. Besides, I forgot to take the control rod and had to come back for it anyway. Here.
All right, I'll assist you.
My sister has a knack for attracting trouble. I'm starting to get worried.
What are you doing out here?
We're dungeon delvers, intrepid explorers, just like you.
Kirith, yep, you know Raynor labor, and Kirith.
Well, I'm the genius. Together we make a good team.
This is actually the first quest we're supposed to meet them. I actually missed this the first time through. You seem a bit young for this line of work.
We may be young, but we have a great many talents at our disposal. If you must know, this is our first real expedition. We need to find something to prove our worth to the Academy. Then, the Archmage will have to accept our applications.
What Academy?
The Academy of Shadastula, of course. My sister and I, we don't come from a wealthy family. We need to find something of magical or historical significance to impress the Archmage so he'll let us study there.
What are you hoping to find?
Something old. Something powerful. Something that will impress even the jaded Archmage of the Academy. All of the greatest Dunmer leaders attended the Academy, and it would be unfair to the world to deny me my place among them.
I already asked that. Okay, we're on our way inside. Gotta believe in something. Well, there's something I need to double check real quick before we get really started on this quest. Oh yeah, I haven't even started the precursor. I'm probably not even going to bother with the precursor on this playthrough. Kirith?
About time you got here. I've been dodging spiders for what seems like forever. Wait, you're not Raynor.
Not at all, but he did send me to bring you this control rod.
Did he? I bet he got hurt fooling around with the spider constructs.
That's not exactly how he put it, but yes.
How typical. Listen, this ruin is a two-person job. I need someone to cause a diversion so I can sneak into the next chamber. Could you test that control rod on the spiders inside?
What's the control rod do?
How should I know? Raynor built it. He calls it a control rod. I bet it controls the constructs. Use it to capture one of those spider things. It might take a few attempts, though. Raynor's devices don't always work exactly as he designed them.
That sounds pretty reckless.
That's the spirit. Now, go create a diversion.
If you're wondering why I didn't intimidate her, it's because she's a friend, and we do not intimidate friends on this channel. Okay, Miri, I'm going to have to put you away for a minute. No, wait. Darn it. Got it. Let me get Mary back out. Unfortunately, Miri does not know how to halt her murder, because she's just like, murder, and rushes forward with her sword. I'm like, Miri, stop, I have to do something. It's like, no, I have to kill. That girl knows no restraint.
What took you so long? And who's your sparky new friend?
I used the rod on the spider, and now it's following me.
You mean my brother's invention actually worked?
It would seem so.
I wonder if it would work on the big spiders.
There are bigger ones?
Probably not. Just a legend. I'm almost positive.
Almost positive.
Anyway, there's something important here. I can feel it. Something the Archmage won't be able to ignore.
What makes you so sure?
Look around. I had a quick peek at the machinery in here while I was waiting for you. I think this entire chamber is some sort of complex dwarven device.
What does it do?
I have no idea. It might open that big door over there, or it might unleash a giant walking teapot with razors for arms. There's only one way to find out, right?
How does it work?
I'm not sure. Its emitter thing is broken. I could fix it if I had some spare parts. Maybe we could get your sparky little friend to help us.
But what if we get the razor arm teapot?
Oh, don't be such a baby. You sound like my brother. Anyway, its emitter thing is broken. If I had some spare parts...
Razor or teapot. What can the spider do?
Dwarven constructs scavenge parts to repair themselves. They're designed to remove delicate mechanisms from disabled constructs to reuse elsewhere.
So you want me to go collect spider parts?
No, not you. Your spider. You just ruin the parts prying them out. Go beat.
This is why the elves destroyed the world.
Then have your sparky friend collect their parts. I'll wait for you by the emitter at the other end of the chamber.
To be fair, it was primarily the Dwemer, but now we have two elf haters in the chat, M Sharp and Fedor. Do I have to kill them for it to work? Elves deserve the hate. Now, do you have any problem with the Falmer, M Sharp? Because the Falmer were just kind of like... Are there actually five of them? I thought there was only one. At least the one scene in Skyrim.
Good timing. I think I almost have this contraption figured out. Did you get the parts?
Spider did most of the work.
So Raynor's control rod actually works? Do you believe it? Let's see those parts. I think I know how to fix this thing.
Complete quest.
Now stand back and give me a moment.
Take your time.
Turn this, tighten that, and finished. That should do it. Should we see what this thing does?
I suppose so.
Ivivec, this is incredible.
What's this thing?
Some kind of elaborate dwarven device, obviously. See the crystal prism set up around the chamber? This emitter fires a beam that reflects off the prisms and then does something. Oh, this is so exciting!
It doesn't look quite right. I'm sure you can fix it.
Maybe. The prisms might be out of alignment. I think we need to direct the beam of light to a specific point. Adjust the prisms until something happens while I work on the emitter some more.
I don't remember there being a vampire falmer in ESO. I'll have to look that up because I've done a lot of ESO, but I don't remember seeing a vampire falmer. Oh, you're talking about... Okay, sorry, my bad. You mean the brother of Paladin Gullibrand. And it's actually quite impressive that he's been alive so long. I wonder how he extended his life. Yeah. I kind of wonder how he extended his life so long to not die, because normally you have to use necromancy to extend your life for that long. It says I'm supposed to be getting the key from the Great Spider, but there is no Great Spider to use the key on, to use the rod on. That's fair, it could be a blessing from Ariel. Ariel is the god of time, so, there we go. Because Ariel and Akatosh are the same god.
Raynor showed up right after you went inside. We heard scary noises from behind the door. What was in there?
A giant spider construct with this Dwemer relic.
A giant spider? I knew it. Can I see what else you found?
You said it was a rumor. Here you go.
This could be just what we need. I bet this gets me and Raynor into the academy.
Glad I could help.
Here's something we found near the ruin. Please take it for helping us. You know, you're not bad to have around. Feel free to come dungeon delving with us whenever you want.
the late Finn. Oh, hey, the name of this quest was actually a reference to Terry Pratchett, one of my all-time favorite authors. The Late Fantastic was the second novel in his critically acclaimed Discworld series, right after The Color of Magic. Although I do not recommend starting off with that those two books if you're going to start the Discworld series. In fact, Neil Gaiman, Terry Pratchett's best friend, doesn't suggest starting with them either, because they're very hard to read. My first Terry Pratchett Discworld books was The Amazing Morris and His Educated Rodents. Weird Sisters and Guards Guards, those are the ones that got me into the series, and then I listened to The Color of Magic on digital book. It was actually my mom that got me into the Discworld books, because she read Terry Pratchett, and she, when I got to a certain age, she figured I might like it, because I liked fantasy stuff, so... And she got me The Amazing Morrison's Educated Rodents, and I read it, and I loved it, and then I just started, like, consuming Terry Pratchett's books. I have almost all of the Discworld novels, currently. I need to finish collecting the rest of them. I might ask for that for Christmas, and ask for the Discworld books that I'm lacking for Christmas this year. She got me a bunch of them last year for Christmas, so... Discworld is really fun. I love Discworld. I want to eventually run a D&D campaign in Discworld, or D&D or Pathfinder campaign in Discworld. The only downside is you can't play as an elf in Discworld. Yeah. The elves are safely locked away where they're not, where they can't do any harm. The downside, you say? And, oh, another one, you can't play as a gnome, because the gnomes are, like, tiny in that universe, so you can't really play a gnome either, because the wee MacFeagle literally ride birds, and they, like, they can live for weeks off of a single loaf of bread. It's, like, really weird, actually, come to think of it. But the reason why I say Pathfinder is because in Pathfinder there's an adopted ancestry feat that humans can get access to at level 1, which allows them to take feats from another race. So I could totally make Captain Carrot Ironfounder son in Pathfinder. The guy who literally oozes charisma. Why aren't the raiders attacking us? I told them to not attack. It's like, you can't tell them to not attack. They have two orders, attack and eat. They don't have any other settings. I convinced them not to attack. We're surrendering. But sir, we outnumber them 12-1. Like, this man can make water run uphill and he has a commander? No, we're not. I don't want any part of this. Yeah, I have to agree with you there. The Pathfinder 2nd edition in Pacific is incredibly good for that. Like, there's just so much diversity. I know some people like the simplicity of 5e, and I have to admit it. There are half-elves, yes, so you could play as a half-elf. That is a true statement. But it's incredibly rare for there to be half-elves anymore. They're kind of, like, really diluted. So while it is possible, you wouldn't get a lot of half elves. So there probably wouldn't be like half elf communities or anything like that. So you'd probably spend a lot of time blending in with human culture. But the vampires are fun. Well, you could just use the dampier. Like lineage, and then just modify it so it's a full on vampire. And then you could have the red ripeners, pretty easy like that. Not one drop. They are vampire abstainers. They do not drink human blood. Lips that touch ichor shall not touch mine. Poor Vimes tried to hold out on getting a vampire in the watch for the longest time, and then his hand finally got forced, and he had to recruit a vampire. I mean, to be fair, he had a zombie, he had a werewolf, he had a troll, he had dwarfs, lots of dwarfs actually. He had some gnomes, at least one gnome. I think he had a lot more trolls than just one, because I think Detritus had an entire troll squad at that point. And I love that Detritus was the drill sergeant, like teaching them their paces. We sing while we run along, we sing this stupid song. I forget the words, so just sing along or I smack you in the head. Oh. I love the Discworld. I was so sad the day I heard that Terry Pratchett had died. That was a sad day for me. Oh, they're having a PvP duel over here while they're waiting for the Dolmen to drop.
This looks ripe for adventure. Maybe a tad overripe.
And the trolls in Discworld are not actually, like not the trolls that you would think of, Joe, since I know you're not familiar with Discworld. The trolls are actually, they're, like, people that are made of rocks. And, their brains are made of silicone, so they're not very smart when it's hot out. During the winter, or, like, in very cold places, their brains are, like, supercharged. And they can think normally. And so most trolls live in the mountains. There's a few exceptions to this. There's Clerophase. His brain is special, so he doesn't actually suffer too much from the troll like brain frying. And then of course there's Mr. Shine, him Diamond. He is a diamond troll, and so he reflects heat, and his brain is constantly operating at maximum capacity no matter where he is. And typically, trolls have are named after the type of rock that they're associated with. Like, for example, detritus looks like he's made from detritus, while diamond is literally made from diamond. And what's even cooler is trolls actually believe that time works in reverse. So they believe that like the future is actually the past, and everything like what we consider the past, they consider the future, and we're like moving towards the past instead of like moving towards the future. So instead of saying things, you know, long, long time ago, they say, you know, a long, long time ahead, because in their beliefs, you know, everything is, yeah, it's kind of confusing until, like, you have to really read the books to get the full gist of it, but it's just the way they are. And naturally, if you're going to run a Discworld campaign, you've got to have all the best characters show up. Navi Knobs, Fred Colin, Commander Samuel Vimes, Lord Vardanari, the Tyrant of Ankh-Morpork, self-claimed tyrant. He actually fully acknowledges the fact that he's a tyrant. He does not lie to you. He is straight up that he is a tyrant. Moist von Lipwig, yes, Moist has to be in it. And of course, Adora Bell. Adora needs to be there as well, his wife. Lady Sybil, naturally. Carrot, Angua, Cheery Little Bottom, Detritus. Sally, the vampire that joined the Watch. Going through my mental list of characters. Nanny Ogg, Margaret, maybe Agnes too. I don't really like Agnes that much. Like, I really regret that he replaced, not Agnes, maybe it is Agnes. It's the girl that he replaced Margaret with in the Witch's Coven. When she got married and, gave birth to little baby Esme, the Princess Esmeralda. Check Margaret. Check spelling of Lanker. And unfortunately, there was nothing they could do about it because the Lanker beliefs say that, you know, what you are named on your naming day is your name, and there's no way around it. Because Margaret definitely would have fixed her name to Margaret since her mother didn't know how to spell if she could have, but unfortunately, that wasn't an option for her. Okay. Did I grab the sky shard? Yes. Yes, I grabbed the sky shard. Oh, can't forget Death. Death and Susan as well. Maybe Lobsong? Like Susan's... I don't know. Did Lobsong and Susan get together? Like the daughter, the granddaughter of Death and the son of Time? I don't know. That would be an interesting combination. Because she's mostly human. He's mostly not. Oh, and of course, Sweeper has to show up at some point. Because what is a crisis on the disc without Sweeper showing up at some point? I just reached for my water and realized that I'm completely out of water. That's sad. My bottle's empty. Okay. We are actually making very decent progress at this zone. I don't think we're going to finish it today, but we won't have much left to do the next time we do it. Yeah, because we got Deshaun Adventurer back in February of 2020. I'll be right back. There's another sky shard to nab before we do that one. Soon. There it is. It's waiting to get nabbed. Oh, the Ebony Blade history. Lorebook recovered. The deal, only one left to go.
You lead. You know, I like to think I'm agreeable.
Teleon's Crag. Yeah, there's four sky shards left, two striking locales, this is the last dungeon, one standing stone, one crafting station. Which I think might be the one that's over by the lake, which I actually missed when we were in that area. Oh well. This is actually a very small dill. In fact, it should not be this bright down here, but it is. Like, look, that's a ceiling. There should not be sunlight shining down, but it's definitely not. See, this is what the light should look like through the entire dungeon. See, up here makes sense. There's a giant hole in the roof up here. But I think because they put in a hole in one place, I think the system auto-generated sunlight in other places that's not supposed to be. That's weird. There's actually... That's considered a part of the map, which is weird. The boss should be right there. Perfect. We are getting out of here. We got the Sky Shard and we got the boss. Okay. I have a fairly good idea where the next, I got stuck for a second. Alright, that's that. Yeah, so as of Tuesday, they're actually going to make it so you can see sky shards on the map when you get close enough to them. So that's going to make hunting for sky shards during streams way easier. In fact, I should not be leaving any zone without collecting all the sky shards in the future after this. So, ooh, lore book. Then mill bridges. Glad I got that one now. That one can actually be a pain in the butt to find. Oh, great. A mini dolmen. Alright, that's another sky shard down, two to go. For whatever reason, I didn't actually get that point of interest over this way. Okay, that's all the striking locales done, so that should be the Pathfinder achievement. Yep, there we go, Deshaun Pathfinder. Alright, where are those last two Sky Shards? The right tower is Teldilic's left, and where ships dock in Mushroom's Mire. That would be the Silent Mire, so... Oh, I know exactly where the last two are. We're, I take back what I said. We might actually finish Deshaun today. Which would be great. Getting two zones completed would be way better than getting some of Clockwork City done today. There it is. One of the last two Sky Shards. Alright, and the last one should be right over there. And then all that's left is the last standing stone and the crafting station. And I can turn in this quest since we're going to be in the town anyways. I can just go ahead and turn in this quest while we're in the area, get the experience and gold from that. We'll do that first, actually, because if I'm quick enough, I'll get the experience from the scroll still. I don't think I'm going to make it.
You'll have to come back later, I'm afraid.
I'm not going to make it. The scroll's going to wear out first. Adventure at the moment. Your master won't be coming back. I found this.
Oh, dear. I knew this day would come. What's the procedure for this? Oh, yes. House Redoran thanks you for your service. Go with our gratitude.
Unfortunately, just shy of getting the benefits from the scroll. The weird thing is, I still got a half an hour I would normally do in the stream, so I could totally start another zone once I get all this done. I think I'll pop over and check on that. Oh, and I'm missing the... I'm missing that crafting station, okay. I'm gonna pop over and check on that dolmen real quick, see if I can't get that out of the way. Since we got plenty of time. And we can make our trip go a little bit faster by using the Way Shrine. And if it's not up, we'll just hit the Way Shrine and head for that crafting station. Where's that last standing stone? There's one of them. There's the mage. Do I have the mage? I have the mage. The Lord is the one I'm missing, which is right over in this area, anyways. It might be up. I can't tell from back here. No, it's not up. It's down. Okay, that's fine.
Careful! We're headed into troublesome territory.
Nope. That's usually her sign that it's about to pop. But... No, it's fine. Back to the Way Shrine. Yeah. We are eventually, like I said, we're eventually going to do an episode where all we do is just go and do dolmens. But not anytime soon. I'm not in any hurry to get that done, so. Because it'll involve a lot of sitting around and waiting, which is boring, so. I'll probably won't do it as a mainstream. I'll probably do it as like a side stream one day when I'm feeling up to doing it. Just start streaming. Boom. That's all the crafting stations. Just have to go get the Lord Stone now, and then we are done with this area for the time being. That's not where the Lord Stone is it? Hold on. Nope, that looks right. Oh, it's on the other side of the... Oops. It's on the other side of the academy. Why didn't Mary disappear? I already had the Lord Stone. Which one am I missing then? I don't have the Tower Stone. That's the one I'm missing. Just real quick, where's that quest from? Glenumbra, okay, that's...
It'll be good to get away from the family a bit.
Okay. So we just have one Dolmen, a couple world bosses, and some lore books. I am going to say that Deshaun is done, and we are going to head to Shadowfin with our remaining time. Into Shadowfen! Accidentally unplugging my cord. Okay, so the public dungeon is right over here. We are not going to do it today, but I am going to go ahead and get it on my map so that way we can find it either next time, which will be after Deadlands ends. I'll be coming back and finishing going through all these Faceland zones that I've already finished the main quest in. So we will be back to doing the Sometimes you have to go into the crafting station in order to acquire them. Just go up here and acquire the Sangerine's Demons. I'm not sure how to say that. Anyways, we won't be doing this today. I guess I have to go into to get it though. So we'll step inside and then we'll come right back out.
See, if I'd taken up trade like my little sister, the most interesting places I'd visit would be banks.
Alright, so let's see. Oh my goodness, we barely scratched the surface on this zone. I'm not even sure where to start, to be honest. I'm not even sure where to start. And I really wish I had spent a little more time in the zone when I initially came through it, but of course I didn't because things. And reasons, and I was trying to rush to get into DLC content so I could keep up with the new release or new releases, which I don't regret doing because I really like that I can play the new stuff as it comes out here on the channel instead of getting farther and farther behind. As long as I keep up with new content, I'm good, so I just gotta take it slowly, getting everything caught back up. Alright, we're looking to see if we got the Sky Shard that's above the Mage's Guild. I am unsure, so we're going to go up in there and check. Nope, we do not have that Sky Shard, so we are going to try to get that. Okay, hold on. Jump up. There we go.
Go for a bit of excitement.
Yeah, up here is actually a player home you can purchase if you feel so inclined. It's kind of like a miniature walled-in area. Gonna go acquire the Talvani acquisition camp. How dare you enslave my people?
I can't thank you enough.
I erect the spine of gratitude. Question is, did I finish in the Shrine of the Black Maul? Did I actually get the Sky Shard from there? Yep, okay, I got that one. Well, you know, that delve is up. Let's go do that first. Or not delve, that dolmen is up. Me as well. Since we're already here.
She was the best slave in the Black Forge. Whatever happened to her?
I thought my game was about to crash there for a second.
My subjects failed me. They deserve
to
be destroyed.
Oh, by the way, it's time to meet the cousin of the demonic chicken. Peddler Prizes. Just freeloading. Now, I'll have you know that he pecks out the eyes of the unholy, and he pecks the eyes out of the holy, and may or may not be the cause of 90% of the problems that are happening on Tamriel currently. The chicken, like, Clementis Vile, Nocturnal, and Mephala are just sitting around like, we need to find some kind of plan to take over the world, and they just hear, bawk, bawk, Spook! And the demonic chicken is just standing there and, like, shows them a picture of the crystal tower and, like, yes, that'll work. That'll do it. And the chicken's like, spook, spook, spook! Yes, we'll give you a cut. Alright, so now this guy's shard down. Alrighty. So let's go get the village on the map. We're not going to do the village today, like I said, but we are going to go through here and start acquiring things. So that way when we do go through here, we'll know where everything is. We already did the mine, so we're good there. I'll go ahead and grab Cradle of Shadows as we're passing. I need to get around to doing all the dungeons eventually, too. There's a lot of dungeons in this game that we haven't even started yet. I guess that's not going to discover unless I actually enter the dungeon, and I'm not doing that. I mean, I could. I definitely could, but I don't really want to. Just one of those things, just like with the, eventually I'm going to get around to, wait, okay, that's, eventually I'm going to get around to doing all the world bosses and all the dolmens, and there's all sorts of stuff. Like, this game is, we have a lot left to go before I can put it to bed between content releases, but there will come a day when we're going to be caught up and only, we'll only have to do new content as it comes out, and on that day, I'll start a Skyrim playthrough as the descendant of Rewish, the Mighty Battle Lizard. I've talked about this before a little bit. Maybe not here on this stream, but I have mentioned that that's my plan, is to do a playthrough of this game. I've already done this place. I can't go south, further south than that. Why? Can I turn this way? Maybe. Yeah, this seems to be working. There's a lot of difficult terrain in this zone. It makes traversing it difficult. Oh, I know this place. This is Zook. We'll be back here soon. Got the crafting station. Now I'm going for that Way Shrine, which is right next to the crafting station, actually. Alright, who's blasting me? Dominion. Hey, I'm... No, wait. No, I am part of the Dominion. I'm part of all the factions, technically speaking.
Let's ride!
Okay, White Rose Prison discovered. There's a sky shard that's right over here. We'll go ahead and grab that while we're in the area. I'm about to call it for the day. Pretty sure it's at the top of this tower. Oh, nope, it's at the middle of this tower. And then All right, and I think that's a good place to stop for now. I am going to be getting Rewish ready for the Deadlands, so he will not be. We're not going to be starting off here where I leave off like normal. We're going to be actually be starting probably back in Leowyn. I don't know where the portal to Fargrave is, or if there's going to be a quest that leads us into Fargrave. Because what happened with the Deadlands is, or not the Deadlands, with Clockwork City, we actually had to go through a quest to access Clockwork City via a powerful mage had to take us there. I don't know if that's the case with Fargrave, or we're just going to have access to it by default, or how that's going to work. So I guess we will find that out when the game launches on Tuesday, and then of course when we actually start playing it on Sunday of next week. So I want to thank you for watching if you did, and I can't wait to jump into the next DLC with you guys, which is going to be next week. Everyone, have a great night or a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.